Hi, Executive Leader Lisa Scola here, coming with some tips on when you do events. Now, I have a lot of questions that have been brought up and asked, and I'm trying to try to get to them little by little and share really the nuggets on just that to make these videos short and sweet and easy for you to get what you need out of them in a timely manner. So, one of the things that I have to say when it comes to doing events, it doesn't really matter. You want to tailor it to the event. If you're doing a Halloween event, craft show, thing at the school, back to school, whatever, tailor it to that. Have some items that tailor what they're doing there. You do not have to spend thousands of dollars to do an event. You do not have to have all this product. All you have to have is a smile, brochures, a few products that maybe came in your kit if you're brand new, or things that maybe have people have returned that you can sell, or maybe you have been able to, in the couple campaigns prior to this event, put some things together that were maybe in the demo or things you think they would be interested in buying. Most people are always looking for daily care stuff, you know, stuff that Avon's known for. There's shower gels, there's Skin So Soft oils, some glimmer sticks, not a lot of lipstick, eyeshadows, makeup, personal items like that. People usually, they usually will order those types of things. Now, if you have them because they came, you got them at a meeting, by all means, bring them. I keep my price points at the sale prices. You do not want to put full brochure prices on things when they can look at that catalog sitting there and see that it's cheaper in the book. That's only going to make them order it and not buy it from you right there. So definitely do that. Another thing is I don't normally charge sales tax when I'm at events. That's like their discount. So it's going to be sale price with no tax. So they are getting the best deal they possibly can because these items for me are already bought and I've already taken care of that. So to me, it's just saving that little extra. Let's get on the calculator and figure out it all. You know, keep it maybe round even numbers. If it's on sale at $5.99 in the book, make it $6. Or if it's, you know, $3.49, maybe make it $3. You know, just, you know, you really have to feel it out. But do what's comfortable for you. It's your business and you're going to do what works for you. That's just what I do. I have done events where they are job fairs. Job fairs, I like to have items out that are like why they want to start a business with Avon. Not everybody wants to start a business. It costs money to start a business. Most people come to job fairs because they are looking for a job. They want to punch a time clock. They want $9 or $10 an hour. They want to know they're going to work Monday through Friday. They want to know they're collecting $300 or $400 at the end of the week because that's all they know how to do. They do not know how to work for themselves, to put orders together, to make themselves financially responsible. That's something that is tailored to people who really have a love or desire to want to work for themselves, like you who's watching this video. So, you're not going to get everybody, but use that as an opportunity to get names, addresses, phone numbers, customers. Maybe they know somebody else who might be interested. If you get them when they're buying from you, you might find out that can be a great personal shop or something they may want to do just to save money. If they're in a hard place, they may not want to build a business with it and invest everything they have, but they may enjoy it just for a discount and be a distributor per se to get a discount off of the items that they love. And it's not going to cost them a lot to do that either. So I have a small kit, you know, display with what they would get. Maybe this the pieces of paper, a couple of items, the books, very simple, not a lot. That's a very simple table because it's basically going to be at a conversation that you're having with them. Now, if you are doing these events and you are setting up at craft shows and fairs and flea markets and wherever else you can get your table for the weekend or for whatever and get your product out there, even a garage sale when you're selling it off or putting baskets together because you're donating it to a cause, somebody asked you for a basket, I certainly hope you are putting how to reorder this information on the back of all of your product. I share this, I've shared it before, here's a shower gel, I have it here. It has how to reorder it right on the back with my information. To reorder, the phone number and my website. It goes on everything. It doesn't cost a lot of money. I do them on labels like this, where there's a million of them on here. I don't even know how many are on here, but see how many are on here? It prints off very small. They're very little labels. They're very easy to take off. It's a great thing. You and your family could do it. You can include your friends. Wine night, your order comes. I'll even do this when my customers are ordering it. How do you know how many, of my customers, when they get their stuff, their kids come over and they'll be like, oh my gosh, I ordered all that Nutura and my daughters came over and they took it all home. Obviously their daughters don't have an Avon rep. So did you have that label on the back of even their product? So even if you're not doing events and you're putting your product in a bag that's going to your customer, have your reordering information on it. What if they lose your book? What if you forgot that, you know, whatever, they moved, their phone dropped in the toilet. Your number was in there, right? Well, if you're not calling to follow up, not sending them another book, they don't know how to get a hold of you. Put it on the product. It only takes a minute. Even like this, see right on the back where it says reorder, that reorder, it says reordered from me. It doesn't say Avon in New York. It says Lisa Scola. That's what it says, right? It should have your name on it. Same with this. Look it on the back. See, my skin's so soft. They're going to get it. And you say, is it waterproof? You can spend a lot of money and get waterproof stickers. Maybe you can find them really cheap. I do them myself. Honestly, I've never really had a big problem with them leaking or whatever. And if it's on everything, they're going to find it. This perfume, it's a great, they don't cellophane stuff anymore. Avon takes it all off most of the time for us. So I take everything out of the box and I put it on the bottom. So when they go to look to see what the smell is or whatever, if they don't remember, it says it on the front, everybody looks on the bottom. There it is, how to reorder it. So again, when they get to the bottom of this, if they haven't seen or talked to you, there it is on the bottom of their bottle. Same with the skincare. Take the skincare out, stick it on the back of it. The only thing that you're gonna have a problem with doing are glimmer sticks and some of the makeup items, but even the eyeshadows and everything. If you open the box, which you can open it very easily, right on the bottom of that, you just put your sticker, how to reorder it. This is your business. If you are not putting a label on how they can get it again on your product, you are missing a huge opportunity. If you are set up at a craft show and all of your items are out on the table and these people aren't really interested in Avon, but they're like, oh, I have an Avon rep, or they don't want a book, they don't want to give you their information, whatever it may be, but they buy from you, let them go home with your brochure. They may throw that in the garbage. Let them use your product and see the sticker on the back. A lot of times it works. You need to make sure they're getting your information. Don't forget. So, recapping, keep it simple. Keep your event table simple. You don't have to spend thousands of dollars to do an event. If you have $25 invested, you want to make sure you're making your $25 back. So bring your product you know is going to move and make it worth your while to customers. If you leave there with 20 or 50 or 100 customer sheets, meaning that you have your little forms on the table, just like I always have, which is name, address, telephone number, very simple, and give away a free sample, give away a little basket or something, have them have a lipstick jar, they can, you know, have games, whatever it is that you can capture their information. Let them know I'd love to service you and get information to you about Avon all the time. So if you don't have an Avon rep, let me be that Avon rep. I would love to service you. So those are my tips. I mean, it's really not hard. I don't want you to complicate it. It's very easy. You don't have to be in Avon for 100 years to do it. You just have to put a little bit of into it. Just please, please, please make sure your labels are on the back of all your product. I don't want them to get done using it and go, oh, now I have to find an Avon rep so I can reorder it. And it could have been you. So hope you like the tips. Again, please like and share. Subscribe to my channel. I hope it helps somebody. And you have a great day.